Peter Strzok, the FBI agent that has been a big topic of conversation with regard to Robert Mueller's investigation, the FBI investigation into Donald Trump. He has been fired. Shimon Prokipes, he's in Washington with all of this. Shimon, what are you picking up?
Yeah, that's right, Kate. The Washington Post reporting that the former now FBI employee, head of the Russia investigation at one point, the Hillary Clinton investigation at one point, has been fired by the FBI. He was fired on Friday by the deputy director. It's not clear, at least from this story, as to what ultimately led to this decision. His lawyer confirming it for the Washington Post. Of course, as we know, Strzok has come under fire by Trump, by others on the Hill. So his firing will probably come at a time for them where they're going to essentially be happy about it. I'm sure the president, who's been calling for his firing, his removal for quite some time, that has now happened. According to the Washington Post, he was fired on Friday.
All right, Shimon, thank you so much. I'm looking at the Washington Post reporting as well. Let me bring in Josh Dossie, Washington Post reporter. Josh, this is coming from one of your colleagues. On this, this is a very important moment. Obviously, Peter Strzok is the FBI agent. He was taken off the investigation when these text messages were revealed. Off the Mueller investigation when the text messages were revealed. He's been something on desk duty to this point, and now, according to your colleague, he's out.
Well, I'm just hearing of this for the first time on here, too, so I don't know a ton, but I will say he's certainly been a favorite punching bag for the president. I mean, the president's tweeted about him, day after day after day, and has really elevated him and Lisa Page.
Yeah, one of his favorite punching bags of recent.
He's elevated him and Lisa Page, to the forefront of conservative media, a lot of segments on Fox News, a lot of segments on Breitbart, the Daily Caller. On the right, Peter Strzok has really been a figure of particular derision. And during his testimony on the Hill, he tried to explain his text messages. We got in a very tense debate with GOP members, and some on the left tried to, defend him. But it's clear that whatever happened with his text messages have been, larger than life news story, partially because of the president's, propensity and ability to, make it so with just nonstop posts and nonstop comments about it.
Yeah. Nia, let me bring you in. As Josh rightly points out, this has been a topic that the president definitely has focused on a lot. But this also was a very big deal when these text messages came out in this inspector general's report.
That's right. And you saw him testifying on Capitol Hill there in a really explosive series of exchanges there with Republicans who went after him in a very personal way. We'll see what Donald Trump says about this. But as Josh said, this has been a person who has been enemy number one in many ways of this president, used to essentially say that the whole Mueller investigation, the whole Mueller probe was rigged against him. And so now we'll see what he says. I think for some people that are just watching this might say, oh, was he even really still at the FBI after all of that? And of course, he was. And as the Washington Post is reporting now, he has been relieved of his duties.
And as Nia, as we're talking about it, Sam, I mean, when Peter Strzok was on the Hill, when he was testifying on Capitol Hill, it was one of the most explosive multiple hours of testimony that I have ever seen. He defended himself vehemently, saying that those were intimate text messages between him and someone else, and in no way did his personal opinions ever leak into, if you will, any of his work in a professional capacity, defending himself vehemently. But now he's out, and I'm looking in the Washington Post. It doesn't say, it says, of course, he was fired after these text messages had come to light. It doesn't say exactly that the reason given for the firing is not what I'm seeing quite yet, at least in the reporting that I'm seeing. But your reaction to this?
My reaction is that if he was fired by the FBI, that's not because of pressure from President Trump. That's because the FBI is not partisan, and the FBI has internal processes, despite what Devin Nunes and other conspiracy theorists and Russia like to say. The FBI functions, does internal reviews. The Department of Justice has an inspector general and likely reviews his activity and found that it violated protocol.
Josh, I'm honestly looking down at my Twitter feed to wait to see if the president says. What do you think the president does with this?
I imagine that he elevates it and amplifies the message of him being fired. I mean, you've seen the president's repeatedly called for a number of people to be fired. He's called for the probe to end. He's called for lots of actions that the FBI and DOJ have not taken heretofore. And at times when he has, you know, had a revelation that came out that he sees in favor of him, he's talked about it at length and ad nauseum. And it's hard to imagine that the president would not see this as a vindication, even if it is or not. Obviously, the facts are still coming in. I don't know. But it's hard to imagine that the president won't cast this as a vindication of everything I was saying. You know, look, I was right. This guy was fired for bad conduct. And as we've seen, the president often doesn't let facts get in the way of his argument, of how he presents things. And you have to imagine this is welcome news for him.
Yeah, let me get back over to Shimon Prokipes, who's learning a little bit more about this Washington Post reporting. Shimon, what are you picking up?
Yeah, so the other thing I wanted to add, Kate, was, of course, what this means for the overall Russia investigation, right? You now have an FBI, the head, a pretty very senior person, obviously, who was running this investigation at one point. He went to work for the Mueller investigation, was there. He's now been fired. So what does this all mean? And for those who have been arguing that this has been a witch hunt, what does this all mean for those who have been saying this needed to end? And really, what does this all mean for those, you know, including the president, who've said that there's been a rigged investigation, the FBI was tainted in this investigation? You got to wonder how that will play into all of this. And it's certainly an extraordinary step for the FBI to go ahead and fire such a senior level official at this point of the investigation. That is pretty incredible. So they're, you know, hopefully they'll give us some reasons as to why they chose to do so now. You know, we know that he'd been disciplined, he'd lost his clearance, he'd been removed from the office, but it's rare that the FBI takes such an extraordinary step in firing someone. So we'll wait to see what they say in terms of why they went ahead and did this.
Yeah, absolutely. And from the Washington Post reporting, the FBI is declining to comment.
That's right.
Strzok's attorney, though, is commenting to the Washington Post, and I'll just read it for everybody for the context. Strzok's attorney says that the FBI deputy director ordered the firing on Friday and says even though the director of the FBI's office that normally handles employee discipline had decided Strzok should face only a demotion and 60-day suspension, Strzok's attorney pointing this out, and Strzok's attorney saying that the move undercuts the FBI's repeated assurances that Strzok would be afforded the normal disciplinary process. So there seems to be some back and forth in this. Joining the conversation right now is CNN legal analyst, former federal prosecutor Jennifer Rogers is here, as well as former federal prosecutor Glenn Kirshner. Thank you guys for jumping on a little early. Obviously, we're going to talk about something else, but let's talk about this as this breaking news is coming in. Jennifer, what do you think of this?
Well, you know, look, I think he's been fired. The FBI doesn't want him anymore. He's not going to get back in there, right? He already was taken out of this investigation and really anything having to do with anything other than personnel matters. So, you know, I don't think it matters as a practical matter. What is Peter Strzok going to do? He wasn't working on anything of import anyway. He may have legal action depending on, you know, whether he was fired properly, whether he had due process. But, you know, I think for Mueller and his team, it just kind of takes someone out of the way who was still a distraction, you know, not that they had anything to do with this, but they just need to focus on what they're doing. The FBI needs to move ahead with what it's doing. You know, it's too bad for Peter Strzok if he wasn't treated fairly, and he may work that out in civil litigation. But I think everyone else just needs to move on from this.
Glenn, hold on one second. I want to get back to Shimon. He's getting some more information coming in. Shimon?
So we have a statement now from Peter Strzok's attorney, Eitan Goldman, essentially confirming the firing, said that it happened on Friday afternoon, that they were informed by the deputy director of the FBI. Now, according to the statement, they say that the deputy director overruled the FBI's Office of Professional Responsibility, also known as OPR, and departed from established precedent by firing Peter Strzok. They say he's a 21-year veteran. And then the statement says, in doing so, the deputy director essentially reversed the decision of the career FBI official responsible for employee discipline, who concluded through an independent review process that a 60-day suspension and demotion from supervisory duties was the appropriate punishment. So here, again, as I said earlier, this is an unprecedented, it does not happen often, where a senior level of the FBI is fired like this. Obviously, we've had other senior level people fired, and Andrew McCabe, but certainly another person here who was part of this investigation, now fired. So the lawyers here arguing that this is a departure from typical bureau practice and also contradicts Director Wray's testimony to Congress and his assurances that the FBI intended to follow its regular process in this and all personnel matters. So clearly here, Kate, the attorneys here are saying that they did not follow standard procedure. So they're going to have some questions. Certainly, I think others will have questions. But nonetheless, obviously, a significant development,
yeah,
really, in this entire story, in this entire investigation, and what Peter Strzok meant to all of this politically, and perhaps even legally in this investigation, now fired. And also, I want to point out, Peter Strzok was a 20-year veteran, and what he meant to the FBI in terms of his knowledge on the counterintelligence investigations, on Russia, also on China. I mean, he led these investigations for all these years, and he's now been fired.
That's an important perspective in all of this. Glenn, just want to get your reaction. I mean, with everything that Shimon is reporting right there, what Peter Strzok's attorney is saying, come as a surprise to you?
I think we have to wait and see the facts before we can decide whether it comes as a surprise. Peter Strzok's attorney, Eitan Goldman, is somebody that I worked with at the U.S. Attorney's Office in Washington, D.C. years ago. He's a fine attorney. I'm a little troubled when I hear him issue a statement that suggests that perhaps the FBI didn't follow protocol and procedures in reaching the decision to fire him. I hope that's not the case. And, of course, Mr. Goldman is representing his client right now. So that's why I say we have to wait and see the facts, because we've seen that when the FBI or other high leaders of our institutions depart from standard policies and procedures, problems ensue. Let me tell you, I think all of this, Kate, ultimately will end up being a footnote to the larger question, which is, you know, Agent Strzok said some horrendous things, some inappropriate things in his text messages. When Bob Mueller found out about that, he cut the man out like a cancer. He said, "You're fired." And this is Bob Mueller, is somebody who knows how to conduct an ethical investigation. So when he decided that Strzok was inappropriate to be part of the investigation into Russian collusion, he cut him out, and he did it definitively. That's what I think we're going to be heartened by moving forward, and I think all of this will be something of a footnote.
What questions do you have now, Jennifer? Because it seems everyone has a lot of questions about it. I mean, the FBI is not commenting, and who knows if the FBI will, because this does come down to, I mean, we often hear we don't comment on personnel matters, so the FBI might not comment. I mean, I really don't know, but what questions do you have?
Yeah, I mean, the question really at this point, we all know that he did something inappropriate with the text messages, so really the only question is, has he gotten his due process? Has he been treated as he is guaranteed to be treated by the FBI? That's really, to me, the only question here, because we all know that he actually did something wrong. So we'll just have to see how that plays out, you know, whether he gets some sort of relief from a lawsuit or unemployment action related to that. But at the end of the day, he's out. I think he's not getting back in. And I think, you know, Mueller and his team and everyone else is just going to move on.
Yeah, as I was mentioning earlier, the hours and hours of testimony that Peter Strzok offered before Congress a while back, it was just a remarkable hearing. All from beginning to end, we could say. But here is one of the moments that was memorable. Peter Strzok speaking with, this was from his July 12th testimony, Peter Strzok speaking with, answering questions, kind of, sort of, with Trey Gowdy on the committee. Just listen to this moment.
My testimony, what you asked and what I responded to, was that he kicked me off because of my bias. I'm stating to you, it is not my understanding that he kicked me off because of any bias, that it was done based on the appearance. If you want to represent what you said accurately, I'm happy to answer that question, but I don't appreciate what was originally said being changed.
I don't give a damn what you appreciate, Agent Strzok. I don't appreciate having an FBI agent with an unprecedented level of animus working on two major investigations during 2016.
Glenn, do you think that testimony like that contributes to the FBI's decision that we see now?
Yeah, I think everything that Agent Strzok said during that hearing probably factored into the FBI's decision. And I would agree that I hope that Agent Strzok was treated fairly, notwithstanding the horrendous decisions he made early on. I hope he was treated fairly by the FBI leadership, that they found a fireable offense, and that they acted accordingly. And again, we have to wait for the facts to come in, but we really need our institutions to follow their own policies and procedures.
But at this moment, here's one of the facts that we do know. According to the Washington Post, Peter Strzok, the FBI agent who has been, as we've been saying, a very major focus of President Trump's in his attacks on the Mueller investigation. Peter Strzok fired from the FBI, according to the Washington Post, the firing being ordered on Friday.